Welcome to Access Rewind. Have you ever been in need of help? Do you know what to do in case of an emergency?
On today's show, we learned about one of the oldest city departments that has been serving our community since 1865.
We definitely turned up the heat on this episode. So check to make sure your smoke detector is working and get ready, because this episode's going to be smoking today. We're your hosts, Daniel Zarate
and Jessica Hubbard.
And in this episode of Access Rewind, we showcase three great places found only here in the IE.
Make sure to stay tuned and learn more about a delicious burger place that's serving up more than just burgers, sure to make your mouth water.
That's right, Jessica. I personally have been there. The selection is amazing and the food is fantastic.
Looking for new furniture? We found a fabulous furniture gallery that'll be sure to turn your house into a home.
And then don't miss out on our active lifestyle segment with Jackie. She showed us how to have fun for $5 or less. So let's rewind.
Back in time. San Bernardino Fire Department headquarters. This is station number one and home of our very own San Bernardino Fire Chief. Today we're going to find out what goes on in the fire department on a daily basis and the ways in which they serve and protect our community. Daniel, we hear you're going to be getting an exclusive tour. What kind of access are you going to be getting for us today?
Yeah, that's right, Jessica. I'm going to find the coolest item in the firehouse and see if I have what it takes to be a firefighter for just one day. Well, really only more like a couple hours.
And we can't forget, we do have a task coming up later in the show.
That's right. I'm so excited about that task. If it's a competition, get ready to get beat, because I'm bringing my A game today.
You're going down.
All right. Bring it on.
Yeah. But before we go get access, we got to learn a little bit more about the history of the San Bernardino Fire Department.
The San Bernardino Fire Department, formerly known as the Fire Protection Association, began the 22nd of June, 1865, with its first station at 3rd and Arrowhead. This association started out as volunteers only, and their first supplies consisted of only 4 ladders, 24 buckets, 4 hooks, and 4 axes. Well, over the years, the fire department has grown to overcome disastrous circumstances. One of the earliest and most notable blazes in the city was the 1892 Stewart Hotel Fire. This 4-level hotel blaze devastated the structure. Firemen from all over the Inland Empire were enlisted. It was the largest blaze to occur at the time. This department has progressed to what it is today. The staff successfully going through a competitive training program, enabling both men and women to prepare for diverse work conditions and emergency circumstances. The San Bernardino Fire Department continues to be dedicated to the residents' protection and safety, and will for many more years to come. Stay tuned for more Access Rewind.
Welcome back to the show. I'm here with Eric Escoville, the battalion chief here for the San Bernardino Fire Department. We were wondering if you could inform us a little bit about your title and how you became the battalion chief here.
Hi, Jessica. I'd be happy to. As a battalion chief, my responsibility is in a command position in the suppression out in the field. In case of a large incident, we go out and we assume the incident command position for that, and we direct our resources accordingly.
Can you explain to us about the chain of commands and how the hierarchy is spread out throughout the San Bernardino Fire Departments?
At the top of the hierarchy is we have the fire chief, we have a deputy chief, and then underneath that we have division chiefs. There's the battalion chief. Each station has a fire captain also, and he's the supervisor of that fire station in that district. Underneath that is an engineer, and he's basically the driver of that apparatus. And in addition to that, there's either a paramedic firefighter or a firefighter assigned to that station.
And then how does the division of the firefighters work? Is there just firefighters?
And those are suppression forces, and that's what most people see all the time. It's the fire engines and the fire stations. We also have other divisions. One of the most important divisions is our Fire Prevention Bureau, because our job is to prevent the fire before it occurs. We have our dispatch center, and that's kind of what I call our central nervous system, because the information comes in, people call 911, the information comes in, and then there's an output. It's almost like the nervous system. There's an input and an output.
Uh-huh.
And without them, we wouldn't know where to go. We'd have to wait for the screams of help or wait to see a call in the smoke.
Really? So that's a behind-the-scenes, very important entity, right?
Absolutely. Then within the other services that we provide, you know, there's the public education underneath the Fire Prevention Bureau. There's arson investigation. One of the jobs that not very many fire departments have across the nation is a tactical medic team. And what we do is we support our SWAT team with the police department. Our hazmat unit, they respond on all the hazmat. There's our rescue, they go do that. There's our ARF, which is the aircraft rescue that we have out at the fire station.
Oh, really?
So we have personnel trained in that.
And each of these divisions, you have them combined in each fire station, or are they spread out throughout the 13 stations?
That's a good question. They are spread out throughout the city, so each station will have a specialty.
How does the fire department take steps to prepare for an emergency, and how do you guys keep your staff prepared?
Different specialties that I told you about, like rescue and hazmat, what they do is they prepare lesson plans and then teach us, so we delegate some of that to them, and they take a leadership role in doing it.
And so it's a constant learning process.
It's constant, because you know, before terrorism, we didn't think about those kinds of things,
yeah.
And so now we have to deal with those issues too.
All right, so we recently learned about a few big fires that have impacted San Bernardino.
Mm-hmm.
Is there any in particular that you were a part of, or you have any personal experiences you would like to share?
Yeah, I think the biggest fire that I've been on, and one in very recent history in 2003, was the Old Fire. I remember I was training here at this fire station. I was assigned to that incident for over a week. Just a very exhausting, very stressful incident. We would do our very best because we couldn't hook up to a fire hydrant. We'd do our best to put out the fire that was there at the time, and then we'd go fill up our tanks on the fire engine from a hydrant and come back, and the house was burning down. And so that was extremely frustrating. It becomes a natural disaster at that point, and there's not too much that we can do.
Yeah.
You know, it seems like every decade we get a major disaster, and it's unfortunate, but our firefighters, we have a good group of trained, tested, and proven firefighters.
Yes, that sounds great. Well, thank you so much, Eric. We've learned
thank
so
you.
Much about the San Bernardino Fire Department, as well as the programs you guys offer here. And we're gonna go check out Daniel over there and see how he's doing on his tour. Daniel?
Thanks, Jessica. I'm standing outside of the fire department where, coming up, I will be getting some inside access, and I'm gonna see if I have what it takes to be a firefighter. But before we get started with the tour, let's take a quick break and check out a local business that sells high-end furniture for very affordable prices.
Once you first walk into Home Gallery, we see a very high-end, expensive furniture. We offer better quality at very low prices. Here at Home Gallery, we offer a variety of style of furniture, from dining, bedroom to living room. We have jewelry boxes, picture frame, lamps, nightstands, coffee table, end table. You can pick out a casual dining or a formal dining table. Any name brand that you can think of, we can offer it for you. Most of them is local here within Southern California. Customer doesn't have to have a designer. We can help them to decorate the way they like. Just pick out the color, and then manufacturer will be able to custom the way that you want. You can finance the furniture. The layaway is pretty much very easy. If you need a delivery service, we have our own truck. Home Gallery is unique because we care about the consumer need. We offer a great service for them, make sure that they're happy and satisfied with their products that they purchase here at Home Gallery. Customer come in and find the furniture that they like and walk out happy with the purchase, and they always seem like they call back and say thanks, and that's what makes me happy. Home Gallery located at 999 Southeast Street. Our phone number is 909-889-5655. We offer low prices and a customer service satisfaction guarantee.
We're here with Manny Sedano. He is a public education officer for the San Bernardino Fire Department. He is in charge of providing public safety awareness to the entire community of San Bernardino. Welcome to the show, Manny.
Thank you.
I'm really happy to be here. I'm sure our viewers are happy that we're here.
So as soon as I walked in, I noticed all these items on display. How about we take a walk and you tell me a little bit more about some of these items?
Sure. The stuff over on, in the wall behind me, that's just memorabilia from some of the stuff that we've done in past years. And that's just old hose nozzles. We also have some old logbooks. That's what the captains used to use back in the day when we didn't have computers.
That's pretty amazing. You got some great badges right in here. These longer things right here, these are fire nozzles?
Fire nozzles,
I thought exactly. They were like trumpets or something to let you know that there's a fire going on.
Yeah, they kind of look like that, but they're actually nozzles.
That's pretty amazing. Then we got some old fire helmets right over there. So I'm noticing as I take a look around at this room, we have a couple offices over here on our left-hand side, and we have the Bureau of Fire Prevention on our right.
On the other side of the building, we have our administrative part of the building, and that's where the fire chief resides. And next to his office is the deputy fire chief.
All right, excellent. So let's take a look down the hallway. I see some more memorabilia. I see a lot of pictures and a lot of plaques on the wall. Why don't you go ahead and describe some of these items to me?
Yeah, as you walk down the hall, if you look over to your right, the first thing you're gonna see is a bunch of pictures. And those are the past fire chiefs of our fire department. And 18 of those are actual city, San Bernardino City residents, or they lived here in the city of San Bernardino. Our current chief, one of the things that people should know about him is that he was born and raised in the city of San Bernardino, and now he's back to oversee the fire department.
So a little bit further down the hallway, I noticed that there was a classroom type setting inside the firehouse.
Now we have a classroom, and that classroom isn't only for our firefighters. We sometimes put on classes for other fire departments to come down and take some training that they need. We also do classes for the community.
That's great, that's City of San Bernardino. The fire department does that for its citizens.
Okay, well that wraps it up for me. Now we're gonna take a look at the fire suppression unit.
All right, thank you so much, Manny Sedano. I really appreciate all the information you gave us and for giving us some inside access on this part of the tour. Let's go check out the fire suppression unit. All right, I'm here with Mike Arvizo. He is the public information officer here at the San Bernardino Fire Department. Welcome to the show, Mike.
How you doing? Thanks.
So we are in what they call the suppression unit, right?
Right.
So what exactly happens in the suppression unit?
This is where we do all of our training, and if we do have any downtime, this is where we're going to be. We got a lot of studying to do, a lot of training.
What is the most common type of call that the fire department receives?
Well, the most common would be a medical aid call. Heart attacks, down to asthma attacks, shootings, stabbings, that kind of thing. We do have paramedics here that work at this department.
So we're talking about the role of firefighter. I've heard of terms, there's a firefighter, there's an engineer, there's a paramedic. Can you describe to us some of the differences?
Yeah, sure. The paramedic, basically it's a paramedic / firefighter. So we go to a fire, they get out, they pull the hoses, they put the fire out, that sort of thing. And then the engineer is the guy that drives the engine.
Oh, wow.
And then there's a captain that's basically in charge that takes care of the crew and makes sure everything gets run correctly.
Yeah, that's definitely, you have to know what you're doing if you're gonna be driving that truck around. I know if that was me, be driving all crazy. So this is obviously the eating area. You got the whole rec room here. We got a big kitchen. You guys got huge refrigerators. I see 6 different refrigerators right over there, probably full of tons of food. Your entertainment center. I see we got a big, huge TV. What kind of stuff do you folks watch on TV?
We'll watch the news, find out what's going on.
Watch the news?
Around.
Any Access Rewind by any chance?
Yeah,
oh, got that. You guys got that TiVo, right?
We got TiVo.
So is this the only part of the suppression unit here at the San Bernardino Fire Department?
No, actually there's a few more offices. The dorms, where we sleep, if we can.
If you can. Weight room in there, it's pretty good. You guys do a lot of physical training?
We try to do it, but if we get interrupted right in the middle of it.
Excellent.
But as much as we can, like this.
Like this? Oh, we got a call coming through.
I'm gonna have to go right now.
Well, that's like a first. We just had a call come in. All right, so we just got a call over the system here, the alarm system that you folks have. Do you have any personal stories about, there's a call coming through, you're doing something really maybe private? I don't know, maybe you're taking a shower or something. You just had a burrito.
It's always, you got back from a fire and you're sweaty, smelling like fire or whatever, smoke, and you go in and take a shower, and obviously every time you do that, you're gonna get a call. So.
I noticed that in the fire engine room, there's different sized trucks. Obviously there's a big ladder truck, there's a smaller truck, there's even a smaller, very mobile SUV. Mm-hmm. Can you describe to me some of the differences between all those vehicles?
Well, I'll start at the small one, the fire SUV. Yeah, that's the one that the battalion chief drives around in. The next one up from that would be the regular fire engine, which actually has water on it, has a tank, 500 gallons. And then the biggest piece of apparatus was ladder truck. Has all ladders on it, has specialized equipment, chainsaws.
Does that one also have, you know, we've heard of the jaws of life, machines like that. Is that the fire engine?
That's all in the ladder truck.
All right, that's very, very pretty interesting information. I'm glad we were able to find out a little bit more about what you do as a firefighter. I bet running calls all day probably gave you an appetite. So let's check out a great place to eat on East Street where everything on the menu is under $10. And I hear the fire chief has personally enjoyed this popular burger joint. But don't go away, because coming up, me and Jessica are gonna be assigned a task from one of the firefighters, and I hear it's very physical. Stay tuned.
Burger Mania is a place where you're gonna get high quality, high quantity without the high price. It's definitely a very family-oriented business. Initially, the idea behind Burger Mania was to start a place where everybody can feel comfortable. We give the service and the quality and the quantity of a dining establishment, but with the quickness and price of fast food. So we categorize that as quick service. One of the biggest things that people miss about Burger Mania is that we're not just burgers. I mean, our burgers are phenomenal. We've pretty much knocked down every burger there is, from Ortega burgers to bacon avocado cheeseburgers. Last week was something new that hit huge. We made our first homestyle burger. The patty is thick and juicy, and it's with a garlic aioli sauce, so there's a lot of herbs and spices, very flavorful. But I have everything. I have breakfast, I have lunch, I have dinner, I have salads, I have healthy food. So really, I have everything in one. We're always creating, we're always in the kitchen cooking. People love to see what we're gonna come up with next. East Street right here is actually where they kind of migrate to eat lunch. You see our lunch rush. There's a lot of people, blue collar men, law enforcement, fire department. There's a lot of people that kind of come around this area. And dinner, you'll see the residents and the families and all that. So I kind of wanted something that was in the middle that can cater to both sides. Burger Mania for me is my life. I love to take care of people. I just want to become San Bernardino's spot. I want everyone in San Bernardino to know that the best place to go is here. Burger Mania is located at 930 South East Street in San Bernardino. And you can also visit us on our website at www.burgermaniaworld.com. So come to Burger Mania, whether it's on your lunch break or with a family, and enjoy our quality food and service and become a part of our family.
Welcome back, Daniel. Well, as you all know, each show will be assigned a specific task depending on location. Since we're here at the fire station today, we are curious to see what our task will be.
Well, are you guys ready for Operation Access Challenge?
Yeah.
All right, yeah, let's heat this up.
All right, well, this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna simulate a fire call. Actually, we're gonna have a guy come out and show you guys first how to put the gear on.
All right.
And then you guys are gonna go in there and come running out like we're actually getting a call. And then you guys have to do it within a minute.
Within a minute.
Whoever gets done first, we'll let him go on the engine to a call.
All right, so for your challenge, this is firefighter paramedic John Marini. He's gonna show you guys how to put the gear on.
First things first, you gotta get the boots off, right? So I've got zippers, so get them on quick. Step into your boots, tuck your can in, and pull up.
Well, that's pretty easy so far.
From here, suspenders up and over, buckle your pants. Snap, Velcro, snap. Next thing you're gonna do is get your Nomex hood on. Next, put your coat in, thumbs through the holes.
Okay.
Zipper. Velcro, snaps. One, two, three, four.
This is way too much work.
Up and over, get it settled. Pull your straps down by pulling these two pieces right here. Seatbelt buckle,
that is
around
amazing.
The waist strap, and then pull it tight.
That is amazing.
Yeah, that's like step 800.
Helmet on. Gloves. You're not done until you get gloves. And the gloves are usually the hardest part.
Sweet.
And then we're done to clap.
Boom.
That's it.
Yeah.
All right. That was easy.
All right. So let's go ahead and get this challenge started.
All right. Let's do it. Come on, Jessica. So start running.
And get out of the way.
All right. We got 1 minute. No, scoot over.
Is that mine?
Sucka! All right, here we go. Where the boots at? How is she ahead of me? This thing is rigged.
Yeah, these are not a size of 36.
You feel like a size 32.
Okay. I think I'm doing it right.
It is really hot in this thing already. I don't know how you guys do this.
Can I be in that bitch?
My life.
Okay.
Hey. This is the hardest part of the whole thing. What? No. This girl wins.
Can you make it up there?
Oh my gosh! Yes! I see Daniel.
Oh no! I'm afraid to get down. So how do you feel?
I feel really emasculated right now. I can't believe
you
beat me in that task. Well, yeah, but that was a really tough task. I really can't believe all the equipment firefighters have to put on when they go out to a call.
I know.
That's ridiculous. Under a minute, I think that took me like 2.5. Want to know another way to bring up your adrenaline? Before we go, Jackie's gonna tell us about skate nights at Stardust.
This is your access to an active lifestyle. I'm Jackie Jules. Today, I'm gonna give you an exclusive look at an awesome hangout, the Stardust Skate Center in San Bernardino. This place has tons of fun to offer without putting a dent in your wallet, so let's go check it out.
First of all, roller skating is a very low impact way to exercise and burn off a lot of calories.
That's right. Skating is a fabulous workout. And with great prices and specials throughout the week, Stardust Skate is definitely the place to be. To do, from roller skating lessons, speed skating, they even offer fully catered parties. Tell us about Stardust Skate.
It's a cool feel, definitely family oriented. It's a cool vibe, but I've been skating for a while.
Are you having a good time?
Oh yes, yes, very much.
Describe Stardust Skate in one word now.
Exciting.
Awesome. Great.
Terrific.
Amazing. Fun.
What a great time here. You should really roll on down. For more information, contact 909-883-1103 or visit their website. I'm Jackie Jules, bringing you an active lifestyle that's fun, fit, and fabulous.
The San Bernardino City Fire Department is such a great resource in our community.
Since 1865, the San Bernardino Fire Department has evolved into a well-built establishment that serves the public on a daily basis. Not only do they fight fires and answer emergency calls, but they educate the public on disaster preparedness.
The San Bernardino Fire Department is ready for anything, and you all should be too. So make sure to sign up for these great classes and learn more about the free programs offered so that you can have access too.
For more information about the San Bernardino Fire Department, visit their website where you can see a list of classes, tips and facts about the fire department. And remember, only call 911 in the case of an emergency. Thank you all for tuning in to Access Rewind. Be sure to visit our Facebook page and our website to see all the segments you saw here today.
And until the next time, this is the only place you'll find everything you need in the Inland Empire. Access Rewind.
A fiery state of mind.
Sign me up. Just go ahead and bail out.
Oh, you get to go on a call?
Yeah.
Oh, hey! It changes everything. At one of the oldest city departments that have been... All right.
Where is he going?
Callaway Hector. Out of the way, man! Dude, no, the guy's like ready behind Hector, like.
That is.